Solve. 6 over x plus 2 equals 1 over x squared plus 2x plus 2 over x. This is what we call a rational equation because it's got these rational expressions inside the equation. And it is an equation because we have an equal sign. Well, just as with any equation with fraction in it, well, remember, rational expression is just a big fraction. We can clear the denominators, or clear the fractions, by multiplying by the lowest common denominator. So what we'll do is find that lowest common denominator. And the process that we use to find the lowest common denominator is to first factor every denominator. So this first denominator is as far as it'll go. You can't factor this anymore, so I'll just write this denominator, x plus 2. Using a different color just to keep these separated, I'll factor this other denominator. And this factors, we can factor out an x, so it factors as x times x plus 2. And the third denominator, well, naturally we cannot factor that anymore, so we'll just write x. Okay, and the lowest common denominator, you can think of that as building these up so that they all look the same. So in other words, what is missing from any of these so that we can multiply by, say, x plus 2 to get it to look like the others? Well, it's missing an x. This one is missing an x. This one has all of the factors. It has the x and the x plus 2. This one is missing an x plus 2. Factor of x plus 2. So this would be our lowest common denominator, this x times x plus 2. When I rewrite this equation, I'm going to write this purple denominator in the factored form. That'll make it easier to see. Okay, I'm going to leave a little space down here, and the way you can clear out the fractions is to multiply by the lowest common denominator. So we're going to multiply everything by this lowest common denominator. Okay, let's show that. So we have this x times x plus 2 over 1 multiplied by our original equation, 6 over x plus 2 equals 1 over x times x plus 2 multiplied by, I'm going to put this in green, I'm showing this lowest common denominator in green, multiplied by that lowest common denominator of x times x plus 2. Let's back that up, x plus 2 over 1. You can always make something into a fraction by just putting it over 1. And then we have plus, let's stay with yellow for our original equation, plus 2 over x times that lowest common denominator of x times x plus 2. And again, over 1. You can make anything into a fraction by putting it over 1. Now, we can see why we did this. The reason you multiply through by the lowest common denominator is that every single denominator is going to cancel out. We've got an x plus 2 cancels with this x plus 2. And this x and this x cancels, and this x plus 2 and x plus 2 cancels. And over here, we have these rational expressions being multiplied. And we can cancel an x from the numerator and denominator. Now what we have left is 6 times x. Right here, 6 times x. We just have 1 in the denominator. So we do not have a denominator anymore. Equals 1 times 1, so just 1. Plus, now we do have to distribute this 2, so just real quickly, this 2 times the quantity x plus 2. So it's 2x and then plus 4 because 2 times 2 is 4. Okay, now we've got a linear equation. Hey, this is pretty nice. They won't always turn out to be linear equations, but this one does. And the process to solve that linear equation is to get simplify each side. So we've got 6x equals 2x plus 5. And then let's subtract the 2x from each side so that we have all of the variable terms on one side. And that leaves us with 4x equals 5. And then last step, divide by the coefficient, divide by 4. And I'll write the answer over to the right here. We have x equals 5 over 4. That is the solution to the equation. That means that if you were to plug in 5/4 in for every x, it would make this equation true.